Hello everybody, let's begin our virtual learning. Subject politics, lesson number 2, federalism. You know, I had talked to you about the key features of federalism. Let me add some more features. The courts, they have the power to interpret the constitution and the powers of the different levels of government. And next feature is that the sources of revenue for each level of government are clearly specified, and not only that, the federal system is having dual objectives, that is two objectives. Now let's move on to the two roots of federations, or we can say two kinds of federations coming together, a bigger unit. Same is the case with us. If we come together, join together with our friends, what is the result? We become more secured. Some examples of coming together federations are USA, Switzerland, and Australia. All the constituent states will have equal power. The second root of federation is holding together federations. In this, the country decides to divide its power between the constituent states and the national government. You have seen in India where the power is shared between the different levels of government. Not only in India, but also in Spain and Belgium, they take the route of holding together federations. I hope it is clear. So children, we are learning about the kinds of federations, or we can say the roots of federations, coming together and holding together. I wish to repeat once again. The first route is involving the independent states coming together on their own to form a bigger unit. What they are doing, they are pooling the sovereignty and they are trying to retain their identity in order to become more and more secured. Whereas in holding together principle, we are seeing that the country decides to divide its power between the constituent states and the national government. And remember that the national government or the central government will tend to be more powerful in relation to the states. You all know that India is a federal country. Now, what made India a federal country is the question. You know, after independence, many princely states became a part of India, and the constitution declared India as a union of states based on the principles of federalism. And not only that, we are saying ours is a federal country because we are having the presence of different tiers of government. Children, all these tiers of government, they are having their own separate jurisdiction. What is the meaning of this word jurisdiction? The area over which someone has a legal authority. You have seen that the jurisdiction of the central government is different from that of the state government.